Assalamu alaikum. Day 28, Juz 28. The true followers of previous prophets and messengers are role models for the Muslim community, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us to be like them. What ayah carries such important command? يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُونُوا أَنصَارَ اللَّهِ كما قال عيسى بن مريم للحواريين من أنصاري إلى الله قال الحواريون نحن أنصار الله فآمنت طائفة من بني إسرائيل وكفرت طائفة فأيدنا الذين آمنوا على عدوهم فأصبحوا ظاهرين. أختر was a famous Indian poet in the early 19th century, who was known for two things. He was known for his strong and vulgar language in poetry, and number two, he was known for his love for alcohol. He was a Muslim, but unfortunately he was surrounded by bad environments and friends, so he was known to party and party a lot. One time he was among his friends and they were drunk and they were enjoying their time, where they wanted to get more poetry out of him. And subhanAllah, these people, maybe when they are drunk, they produce the finest quality of language, subhanAllah. Again, Allahu alam. So his friends would mention to him another poet who is a competitor to Akhtar. And immediately on the spot, he would come up with poetry that insults that guy, that bad mouths him. And then they would mention another person. And they would say, oh, this guy is a bigger loser. And he would come up with poetry, subhanAllah, that's amazing, that's strong, that's vulgar. And everyone is laughing, everyone is enjoying their time. When one of the people in that gathering who was a hater of Islam, he hated the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he threw kind of a comment, hey, Akhtar, why don't you make poetry about Muhammad, Prophet Muhammad? And Akhtar, subhanAllah, was shocked. Although he was drunk, this question hit a nerve deep inside him. He had a bottle of alcohol in his hand and he immediately threw it at the guy. Stop! How dare you mention the blessed name of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam on your mouth? How dare you? You know I'm a sinner. You know I'm not the best Muslim, but I would never insult Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Akhtar left the gathering. We don't know if he became more religious after that or not, or no. We don't praise his lifestyle. We're not saying that he is the best Muslim ever. But something to be praiseworthy is taking a stance when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is insulted and not normalizing this gathering and this environment. What we really appreciate from his position is when he applied in that specific instance, kunu ansar Allah. Be a supporter of Allah. Do not remain silent when Allah's name or when the Prophet Muhammad's name sallallahu alaihi wasallam is being defamed and insulted. Take a stance to support Islam. The Quran is telling the believers, be the supporters of Allah like the disciples of Isa alayhi salam. كما قال عيسى بن مريم للحواريين من أنصاري إلى الله. He told them, who are my supporters to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He showed them the way. The way to Allah is through me, through the messenger. But the final destination is not Isa. He did not say man ansari. He said man ansari ila Allah. And the hawariyun, the disciples, they understood the message. And they said, nahnu ansarullah. We are the supporters of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We understand that the messenger is a pathway, is a road to a final destination, which is supporting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Notice even the language. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not tell the believers, support Allah. Ansurullah. He said, kunu ansar Allah. Be a supporter of Allah. If the command was in the verb format, you can support Allah once, like in a masjid or in a gathering, and then you have fulfilled the command. But to be a supporter of Allah, it's commanding us to live up to that expectation, to become somebody who lives by Islam, breathes by Islam, who is obsessed with helping Islam spread and grow, subhanAllah. And notice that in another ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Al-Imran, فَلَمَّا أَحَسَّ عِيسَى مِنْهُمُ الْكُفْرَ قَالَ مَنْ أَنصَارِي إِلَى اللَّهِ. When Isa alayhi salam noticed, started sensing, feeling that they may tend to disbelief, to reject, to abandon the faith, he asked them this specific question, Man Ansari ilallah, which shows us that supporting Islam, taking a stance, protects your iman, protects your identity. Yes, you might say, I'm not a sheikh, I'm not a scholar, I'm not someone famous, who's gonna care about my stance? You are protecting yourself, you're protecting your faith. We will be protecting our community, our family, subhanAllah. We reduce the munkar even by speaking out or showing that we are not happy with what's happening. The ajr for supporting the munkar is continuous. Wallahi, people sometimes, they are silent listeners and observers. What are we going to say when a certain backbiting or gossip is presented, or a cuss word or insult is presented? People watch and see, are we going to really speak out against it or not? SubhanAllah. Don't say I'm a sinner. Don't say I'm not perfect myself. All of us have our weaknesses, subhanAllah. But all of us can support Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at least by taking a stance. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُونُوا أَنصَارَ اللَّهِ. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all of us supporters to Islam at our level, with our weaknesses, with our shortcomings. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.